Hello everyone, ATR here, and welcome back to the Hearthstone beta. So let's do ourselves another arena run. Last one went down pretty horribly. But what can we do? We are a pretty horrible player ourselves. No more rogue for us. Goodbye. Good luck. Whatever. Warlock. I am not very good or fond of it, but I don't think I've had a Warlock run to show you guys, so we're gonna go with the Warlock now. This, I know I said it last time to remind me and yell at me if I don't take card draw, but with the Warlock, I think it's the only exception where I might not take the card draw if the other cards are favorable, because the Warlock's ability is Life Tap. Draw a card and take 2 damage, so we have our own way of card draw. Obviously, we don't want to rely too heavily on it because, you know, it deals 2 damage to us, but, you know, it makes it a little bit easier to start getting stuff, right? So let's go ahead and choose that Warlock, see if we can get now. Popular things in the ladder with the Warlocks are beatdown decks, you know, getting a lot of stuff out there and just constantly pressuring your opponent. So we're going to see if we can do something similar to that, but let's take a look at what we got. So we start off with a legendary, very nice. Bane of Doom, I've never actually seen this card. Deal 2 damage to a character. If that kills it, summon a random minion. Oh yeah, I've seen this one. So random demon is, you know, like this stuff. This is a demon. You also have the void walkers and things like that. Blood imps. The flame imps as well. So it's random. So it's kind of unreliable. And it's only 2 damage for 5. But it does draw, you know, it gets a demon if it kills. So it's kind of cool. I'm tempted. But we do have 2 other very good choices. Molten Giant, it's a very nice choice for a Warlock because it costs 1 less for each damage your hero has taken, and because of your hero power, you can almost guarantee you're going to be taking damage, so you can get this guy out, you know, relatively quickly and reliably. And then you also have the Pit Lord, Battlecry, deal 5 damage to your hero, but it's a 5-6 for 4. It's okay, I like it, it's, you know, it's very good stats for its cost, but it does deal 5 damage to yourself. So in this situation, I think I'm going to go with the safer-ish route and just get a big guy, an 8-8, that we'll probably be able to bring out at some point in the game because of our hero power. And yeah, this is just too random. I mean, it can summon a couple 1-cost creatures and dealing 2 damage with that only. I mean, it seems too bleh. So yeah, I'll go with the Molten Giant. Start off with the big dude. And here we go, Blood Imp, Hellfire, and Wisp. I like the Hellfire, it's a board wipe, but it does deal 3 damage to your characters and yourself as well. So it's something to be careful of. But, you know, it's very nice, but the Blood Imp is also amazing. It's a 1-1 for 1, it's stealth, and it gives every other minion plus 1. So it's very annoying to remove, pretty much requires some type of AoE to get rid of it. So let's go ahead and take that. Another Hellfire, Acolyte of Pain, and Loot Hoarder. Now, because, like I said, because of the hero power of this guy, I am going to consider the other option, which is a Hellfire, and I'm going to take it, because I can draw cards with this. This is cool for a card draw, kill something, or have it killed, and it draws, and this, every time it takes damage, it draws a card, which is nice, but Hellfire, option available between this. Let's take the Hellfire. Another Hellfire, wow, this deck is trying to tell us something, but we already have one Hellfire and it's giving us a Shadow Bolt. Shadow Bolt is great. It's 4 damage to a minion for 3 costs. That's excellent. That's pretty well rounded. So let's take that. The Oasis Snapjaw was just a pretty crappy beast, so we don't care about that one. Now let's see here. Jungle Panther, Raid Leader, and Mogoshan Warden. Raid Leader is pretty nice because if we do get what we want, we're going to have a lot of low-cost creatures out there, and it gives them plus 1, but I don't know if we're going to get what we want. We're only at the beginning of the deck, so it's kind of a risky thing. It's not that great. It's a 2-2 for 3, which is bleh. Mogoshan Warden, not my favorite taunter. It's a 1-7, meaning it does take a couple hits, but it only hits for 1, so a lot of things can hit it and just stay alive, so it doesn't really matter there. It's essentially just delay of game. And the Jungle Panther is a solid card. It's a 4-2 for 3, and it has stealth, so I think I'm going to take that Panther just to have more threats on the field, so let's do that. Spellbreaker, Dalaran Mage, and Windfury Harpy. In this situation, we're going to take that Spellbreaker for silence. Dalaran Mage is nice for the spell damage, but I only have 2 spells so far, and I'm not sure if I'm going to get more, so for now, we'll take the Spellbreaker, which is very nice. Another Hellfire, but we are getting that Senjin Shieldmaster. This is my favorite taunter. Decent amount of health, hits pretty hard, so it's kind of hard to remove, and it's only a 4 cost. So we're going to take that Senjin Shieldmaster. Murloc Tidecaller. Murlocs are nice with Warlocks, but I can't guarantee that I'm going to get many of them, so we're going to skip that. The Ancient Mage, I just don't like this card at all, and the Abomination is a pretty solid card, and the Warlock already has a theme of dealing two damage to every, I mean, to dealing damage to itself and its own minions, including the Hellfire, so we're going to take that A-Bomb. Another taunt and more. And speaking of that, we're going to take the Dread Infernal because the Succubus is really nice. It's a 4-3 for 2, which is amazing, but it does discard a random card, which I'm not too fond of. I mean, I like it. Sometimes you can get it to work, but, you know, just losing a card is sometimes too brutal depending on what it picks. So I am going to go with the Dread Infernal. It's a 6-6 for 6, a big, heavy, mean guy, and it deals 1 damage to everybody as it comes out. So, except itself. It doesn't hit itself, but it hits everything else. So another type of AoE and just a big guy. So let's do that. Pint-sized Summoner, Mana Addict, and Angry Chicken. Angry Chicken definitely, right? No. Angry Chicken is pretty gimmicky. It's a 1-1 chicken with Enrage plus 5. So you gotta give it at least one more health and hit it so that it becomes a 6 damage creature, but kind of hard to pull off. Mana Addict is nice for burst damage, but it's very hard to get to work properly because, well, one, you would have to put it in a deck where you can give it charge, which pretty much only means warrior. And, well, yeah, I guess it works. Yeah, I mean, I suppose it only works out of the battle with a warrior. Say you drop this and you use the zero cost charge card on it, it gives it plus 2 and you can instantly hit for 3 damage. But, yeah, I mean, usually speaking, you have to drop this in a turn, hope that it doesn't get killed, and then next turn you can maybe drop 1 or 2, maybe even 3 spells and get plus 2 attack for those spells and hit pretty hard with it. Because the thing is that it only keeps that attack value that turn. It becomes a 1 damage creature again afterwards, which is pretty crappy actually. I mean, if it was, you know, persistent, like a lot of other creatures have that, it would be pretty good. But yeah, I mean, this Mana Addict just like that because of that ability. Nope. So the Pint-sized Summoner is going to be our option here. It's a 2-2 for 2, which is meh, but it reduces the cost of your first minion you play on the next turn, or, well, each turn if it stays alive, by 1. So, you know, a little bit of mana efficiency there. So we'll take that Summoner. Summoning Portal, pretty much the same as a Summoner. It just doesn't attack. It's 4 damage, 4 health for 4, and it reduces every minion you summon by 2 with a minimum of 1. You know, they can't be free, but that's a good option. Stormwind Knight, we already used it last time, and it did help a little bit, but we ended up losing very quickly. And the Silver Moon Guardian is a solid card, 3-3 for 4, which is mediocre, but it does have Divine Shield, meaning it usually trades well. But we're going to take that Summoning Portal, and hopefully we get more stuff that we can flood the board with. Here we go, Voidwalker, Harvest Golem, Darkscale Healer. Our Darkscale Healer is tempting here because of the ability to heal both myself and my units, but it is a 4-5 for 5, which is not good. Harvest Golem is pretty solid. It's a 2-3 for 3, but once it dies, it summons a 2-1, which is very annoying. But the Voidwalker is also a very solid card. It's a 1-3 for 1. Compare it to the Footman, which is a 1-2 for 1. So this is downright better, and if you can put a Blood Imp next to it, it becomes a 1-4. So yeah, we'll take the Voidwalker. Also, because I want to get a lot of demons, because if we can get Sense Demons in one of our choices, it's going to make it so that we have a lot of these cards in our hands. So here we go. Wisp, Darkscale Healer, and an Acidic Swampoose. We're going to take that Swampoose, even though, like I said, I kind of am tempted for the Healer. But the Swampoose is very nice. If we're going up against a class that does not have a weapon, we can just drop a 3-2. Or if we are going up against a weapon-heavy class like a Warrior, we can hold it and break a weapon when it gets there. So let's take that. Sense Demons, there we go. Shilvan Yeti, very solid card, but we're going to take that Sense Demons. Direwolf Alpha, Dalaran Mage, and River Crocolis. How many spells do we have so far? We only have 2 still, right? We have the Shadow Bolt and the Hellfire. Nothing else really benefits from it. This guy doesn't benefit from that, so we're just going to skip that Dalaran Mage just yet. We're going to put out that Direwolf Alpha, I guess, and buff up any of our creatures, if possible. Ooh, Demon Fire, Hellfire, and Reckless Rocketeer. Rocketeer, we're going to pass. Demon Fire is very nice. It's deal 2 damage to a minion, or if it's a friendly demon, you give it +2/+2 instead. So we can pump up the Voidwalker to a 3-5. So that's nice. There's also the Dread Infernal, and it becomes an 8-8. So we're going to take that Demon Fire. Another Succubus, Reckless Rocketeer, and the Magma Ranger. Damn it. These are all horrible choices. So the Succubus is the better one. Again, I don't like that discard. a random card functionality of it, but we're going to have to take it. It is a better choice that we have there. And it is also a demon, so. Novice Engineer, Nightblade, and Frostwolf Warlord. Now, unfortunately, due to the way that we have the deck right now, I can't guarantee that I'm going to have a lot with the Frostwolf, so I'm going to skip it for now, as well as the Nightblade, and we're going to go with the card draw just to have more stuff, so. Early, weak minion, card draw. These two guys, pretty mediocre. Another Hellfire is going to be it. Siphon Soul, destroy a minion, restore 3 health to your hero. This is amazing. We can get rid of anything, anything. Crazed Alchemist, pretty nice. Swap a minion's health. Can work on your own or an enemy's. And then Light Warden is +2 attack every time something is healed, and I can't guarantee my heals. So we're going to take that Siphon. That way we can remove heavy stuff. Another Hellfire or another Spellbreaker. The Abusive Sergeant is also nice, but it's only +2 attack this turn. And obviously it requires something already being out. So we're going to take that second silence, just in case. A little bit more well-rounded, covering our bases. War Golem, Silver Moon Guardian, or Stormwind Knight. Have this big guy, so I think we'll get ourselves a second big guy. Yeah, let's go huge. 7-7 War Golem. The Silver Moon Guardian is a 4 cost, but we already are pretty high in the force. Let's go ahead and get a 7. Soulfire, Mortar Coil, and Earthen Ring Farseer. All 3 of them good choices. The Farseer, I'm tempted because, you know, if you heal yourself, you're able to draw more cards. Soulfire is very nice. It's 4 damage at no cost, but it does discard a random card from your deck, which I'm not very fond of. And in Arena, I feel like you kind of have to have all the cards that you, you know, can to make it a little bit more effective. So I think we're going to take that Mortal Coil. Mortal Coil is deal 1 damage to a minion, and if it kills it, you draw a card. So it's a nice finisher there. And card draw. Another Soulfire, another Spellbreaker, and a Silverhand Knight. I may be stupid by not taking Soulfires, but I'm just going to take another Spellbreaker. Oh my god, stop giving me Soulfires. I don't want to use you. Damn it. Okay. Bloodfin Raptor, Jungle Panther, and a Soulfire. We're gonna avoid those. I don't know. I mean, I know they're pretty strong, and I guess in Constructed they're okay, but I just don't feel, since decks are so janky and random, just losing more cards is kind of, I don't know. I just don't like that feeling. We're gonna go with the Jungle Panther. Have 2 of those. Keep them in stealth. Another Ascendant Shieldmaster is nice. Chillwind Yeti is also nice. Deals 1 more damage than this guy, but it's not a taunter. So we're going to use this to our advantage. We're down to 4 cards left. Another Voidwalker will do it. Flesh Eating Ghoul is also nice, but I don't have a lot of weenies here that it can utilize to get big. Another Demon Fire will do it. Although there is a card draw, but like I said, I prefer with the ability just to use that. And we're down to the last 2. Another Direwolf Alpha, a Leper Gnome, or a Murloc Tidehunter. I think I'll take the Leper Gnome. It's a very nice early drop. Deals 2 damage. Deals 2 damage to the hero once it dies. So, yeah, pretty aggressive. Hopefully beating down the enemy quickly. Gives us more 1 drops. And the last card, Sunwalker, Master Swordsmith, or a Demolisher. I do like the Demolisher. I use it quite heavily in my RNG deck, which maybe I'll show you guys later. Big Taunter, potentially a good option. How many taunts do we have? We do have a decent amount of taunts. We have 2 Sentient Shieldmasters and an A-Bomb, plus the Voidwalker, so I don't think I'll take that. The Master Swordsman is pretty random. It just gives 1 attack whenever, you know, at the end of turn to your minions. So I'll take the Demolisher. Our 3 costs are a little bit down, so we'll round it out with that and just toss that, and if it stays alive, it tosses 2 damage to a random enemy at the start of my turn, so very nice. Okay, well, let's hope that this actually pans out, so let's head straight into 1 match, and yeah, pray. Pray to the RNG gods. You guys can probably notice a little weird graphical glitch here. I mean, it's still beta, and the graphic resolution for windowed did get changed with the latest or last patches, and yeah, you can see there it fixed itself, but yeah, you get some weird glitches at the end. But again, beta is beta. You can see it right there at the edge. Look, it's not finishing there, but whatever. So Leper Gnome, very nice to start with. Siphon Soul, we'll toss it back. The Shadow Bolt we will keep in our hand in case something big comes out. So yeah, let's just toss that one out, And we get a demon fire. Okay, this is not a demon, it's a gnome, but that's fine. Greetings.
You.
So, hello. The mage is gonna start off attacking me with 3 damage. That's pretty nice. I'm gonna put out the leper gnome, which forces her to shoot it and do another 2 damage to me, which I am kinda not okay with anymore, considering the amount of damage I've already taken. This is kinda bad, but yeah, let's hold our mana. So that way we can almost guarantee that he's gonna decide to shoot it and hit me for an additional 2. And next turn, I'll probably put out the Demolisher. I mean, at the very least, it hits her for 2 anyway, so, you know, I'm getting some damage out there. No, he actually goes for the card draw. Novice Engineer. Okay, well, that's actually better for me, because that way I get rid of his stuff, hit him for 2, and we are going to pop out a Demolisher out there. Demolisher kind of hard to remove at this point. I believe she can use a Frostbolt for 3, but I don't think there's anything for 4, at least at turn 3, is there? Well, I suppose a Frostbolt followed up by the other one, the Frost Lance, or what the hell is it? Something like that. Could potentially, you know, remove it, but it's kind of overkill, because you do like 7 damage, something like that. So, hits up there for 2, which is kind of annoying, but I suppose it's fine. We're not gonna grow this guy big until it can actually hit. We have 2 demon fires available, which is nice. We could demon fire one of these to get rid of it, but we're not in any real hurry to get rid of the guys. So we're going to Void Walker. Wait, no. Whenever you have to draw a card, always draw your card first. That is something I was always told. There we go. And we get a Void Walker out, and we're just gonna hit for 1. So we have a Taunter, just to protect our guy, who's gonna be keep on getting hit by the mage. Probably gonna use a bolt or something. No, summons another guy. So pretty nice. Unfortunately, it misses again, which is kind of annoying. We are going to, let's see, if we give it +2/+2, it kills that, and that's it. We can't kill this, meaning that this dies. Yeah, we're actually not going to spend any of our demon fires right now. Is that a mistake? Because I'm thinking of shadow bolting this just to kill it, hitting here, and probably hitting there as well. And he would have to hit this next turn and sacrifice against it, and then probably just fire blast it. But
so many.
Yeah, I think it's the right choice. I do have another Void Walker, so it's fine. No, it's no sense in getting big right now. So let's go ahead and hit that. Hit that. And shadow bolt that. There we go. So we utilize the shadow bolt to deal a, you know, exact amount of damage to that minion, making sure that it dies. Tazdingo comes out. He's going to, no, you can't kill that. Yeah, you can hit that, sacrifice that guy, and takes a hit there. Very nice. So now I think, oh, very nice. A Blood Imp. This is excellent. We can silence Ascendant Shieldmaster just to hit and go with this, but that doesn't make much sense. We put out the Blood Imp. It gives our guys +1 health, and then I can Demon Fire this. No, so should I Demon Fire twice? I mean, if I Demon Fire twice, it deals 5 damage and has a lot of health, but we are opening up ourselves to a Polymorph. Do we do this like this? I think we do. The other option is dropping our own Sending Shield Master and just not doing anything. And I don't believe in just not doing anything. Let's just do something. This comes out, this kills and stays in the field. Yeah, let's get rid of this stuff on the field. So comes a 3-4. And then it becomes a 5-6. Boom! Down goes that guy. Going for an additional damage. And we have the board. 3 health left on that guy means a Frostbolt kills it, but that is forcing the mage's hand. Spellbreaker comes out, and his guy stays alive at a 1-3, which is awesome. Yeah, the maths are pretty weird here, so he brings back his Spellbreaker. That's fine. Start our turn, we kill that guy. So we got board advantage. We are going to bring out... In this situation, we're actually... Do we tempt him with Ascension Shieldmaster? Because we know he has that silence, so he can very easily silence our Demolisher. Do we tempt him with a Shieldmaster? Or do we put out a Jungle Panther? I think we tempt him with the Shieldmaster, giving him an option to either silence my Demolisher or my Taunt. Yeah. And then we Life Tap. So let's go ahead and Life Tap first if we're going to do that. Sense Demons. That's nice. We'll use that next turn. We're going to go ahead and put a Shieldmaster to defend our guys. Becomes a 6 health Shieldmaster and continue to hit forward. So... We're okay. Flame Strike is what I was gonna say. That would put us in a kind of a bad spot, but our Shieldmaster stays alive at 3-2 because of the health buff. So what we do now is simply bring out more demons into our hands and put out a Jungle Panther. So we get the Dread Infernal and the Succubus. Succubus, I don't like you because of the discard mechanic, but we are going to put this guy out. And go for 3. No sense in putting up a Void Walker. Another Flame Strike would kill it anyway, so might as well just keep one Taunter on the field to, you know. So this guy comes out. Acolyte of Pain comes out as well. And he pings his own Acolyte to get a card. Very nice move there. How do we do this? If we kill the Mana Worm, he's probably going to sacrifice his Acolyte of Pain by hitting it one more time, getting a card, and then hitting my Ascension Shieldmaster to kill it and kill itself. Getting a third card, giving incredible value to his guy. So I'm thinking we silence it. I mean, I know we do have a couple extra silences in the deck, so limiting him to one silence there is kinda the better option, in my opinion. This deal the 1 damage to all characters doesn't help me. 4. We put another taunt just to have one. 4, 5, 6, 7? Yeah, I guess that works. We don't want to give him more cards, try to limit him as much as possible, so let's go ahead and spell break that. We're going to hit that. We don't want it getting huge. We're going to put another Voidwalker on the field. We're going to get ourselves a Hellfire and attack 4. And we're going to save that coil because we can't actually kill any of those guys. So yeah, at least we limited his guys. He freezes our minions. And he's going to go for the Fireball. Was he actually able to build a freaking burn deck in this thing? Who knows? Okay, well now we're actually in a bad spot because we can't hit him next turn, meaning he stays alive, and he has a Spellbreaker and one more card. If that's a fucking Pyroblast, I'm gonna flip a shit. But so Hellfire doesn't help us because there's nothing for him to kill. We just kill our own guys. Abomination is a possibility to bring out. Spellbreaker, I don't really want to bring out. And if I Life Tap and he does have a Pyroblast, then I'm just killing myself. So I think in this situation, we just bring out the Abomination. And the Succubus. And let's see what we lose. We lose our Dread Infernal. Well, that's bad, but I guess it could have been worse. And which is going to pass. We don't actually want to Life Tap, because like I said, if he has a fucking Pyroblast in his hand, that's... Okay, well that's bad. He gets Deathwing, come on, seriously? And there's nothing I can actually do against Deathwing here. So, the only thing left is to dig for nothing. Nope, that's it. Jesus Christ. That is ridiculous. That is ridiculous, guys, come on, Deathwing and... I mean, how many good cards did he have? I mean, he had... Well, I think I'm projecting there on other carts, but no, my death is just a Deathwing. Who gets Deathwing in arenas? Jesus. Ugh. And I didn't even have a taunt anymore at that point, which is ridiculous. Ah, well. We're actually running short, so let's go ahead and get ourselves another match. I mean, I feel we were doing okay with that deck, but not until frickin' Deathwing comes out. Did I even get a legendary in this draft? No, I didn't get any legendary, so... Jesus. Horse poop. Poop, guys. Okay, well... You win a very few and you lose most, right?
Gul'dan
versus Ceres. Ceres. Okay, warrior. Voidwalker helps out. A molten giant, we're just gonna toss early on, and we're gonna keep that sense demons to be able to. Well, sense demons. Succubus also available. I do hate the succubus, but whatever. Brings out a boar, charges for one. Deals damage to me.
I greet you.
We'll greet him, and we will just simply put out our taunt. So feel free to run that boar into the taunt's face and have it die. Or, of course, if you have Heroic Strike, he's going to cast Heroic Strike and kill my guy. Slam. Deals 2 damage. If it survives, draw a card. Very nice move by him. So he draws a card and clears the board. Okay. Very strong move there. We are going to sense demons to get ourselves another demon because I do not like this guy. And this is what I needed last time. Siphon Soul. Kill that freaking Deathwing. There. Yeah, let's go ahead and sacrifice our card to draw more cards. We'll get ourselves the Blood Imp and the Voidwalker. Very nice. So next turn we have a decent combination. And, well, actually, that's not very decent. Well, decenter. I guess it's fine. I mean, we are not being mana efficient, but it's not all about mana efficiency. So the Pint-Sized Summoner comes out. Pint-Sized Summoner doesn't really do much. Mortal Coil available, so next turn we can probably kill it if he ramps it into the Voidwalker. But yeah, I mean, I don't really see much else. The Direwolf Alpha is an option, though. Could also succubus and see what I lose, but again, if I lose this, I'm putting myself in a very tough spot. I don't want to lose it, so. No, screw you, succubus. I know you're very strong for a 2-cost, but bleh. So, Voidwalker and Blood Imp. And this is where he pulls out the cleave and kills the Blood Imp. That juggler comes out, costing 1, and he has 3 available. Hoping that I can dodge the knife one time against the Blood Imp. No, you can't target the Blood Imp, dude. I'm sorry. It's not how it works. What are you trying to do? Inner Rage? Inner Rage isn't really going to help your guys. I mean... You can cancel it if you weren't able to cast it, you know. You don't have to go all the way, just right click or aim away and that's it.
We must
no? Shattered Sun Cleric. Well. Okay. So out comes the Shattered Sun Cleric, hits my knife juggler, and hits me for 3. Ugh. So there goes my guy. Pretty bad spot for me now. Spellbreaker. I could reduce this to a 2-2, or I can remove the ability for it to cast shit. Probably the better option. I can also drop this guy and this just to have some threats and potentially lose my Siphon Soul, which I don't want to. And it's kind of a waste of a silence, but I suppose I do want to keep my Blood Imp alive, so... I'm just going to put a threat out there, silence that. It dies to 2 of these guys, but it trades favorably unless a spell is used, because it has 4 health, and they can only deal 3 damage, so it's actually good for me. Please no cleave, please no cleave, or whirlwind.
Try this.
Arathi Weaponsmith, okay. His board is starting to get pretty out of control. He's gonna swing at my guy, Yeah, and sacrifice one of his 3/2s. Probably the knife juggler, since it's the least useful at this point. Yeah. So sacrifices that, gets that out of the field, and I'm in bad shape. This guy deals 1 damage to all other characters, gets rid of my blood imp, which is bad for me. And I'm now getting beat down. Hellfire. I think I'm going to have to Hellfire. I don't like the thought about it, but... I mean, the thought of it, not thought about it. But, yeah, we can't let him keep this momentum against us, so we're going to... Well, so I think that's a stupid move just to get another card. Yeah, I'm not going to use that. Okay, so we're going to attack with our Blood Imp, get 1 damage in, and Hellfire. There we go. So, utilizing everything we have at, you know, to the most effect. And now we can deal 1 damage to everything that he puts out right now, hoping that, you know, stuff that comes out has 1 health. So we're not doing pretty well. Not at all.
What now?
What now? Jungle Panther, that's not good. Shield block. Less than great. You say essentially healing up. And another Hellfire. Hellfire is just to remove 1 guy and still take 3 damage ourselves? I don't think so. We are going to Life Tap. Shadow Bolt comes out. That's less than useful. I'm going to put a Dire Wolf Alpha out there simply to have something out there. And I know that I'm probably supposed to run the Succubus out, and it's a mistake just keeping it, but nothing that I have here I actually want to lose. Nothing. So I am going to have to just deal with it and keep on doing that. So the wolf probably dies to his weapon. Yeah. Yeah, probably dies to his weapon. There's no reason to sacrifice his panther against it. He probably doesn't want to leave it alive, considering that it buffs anything else that comes out. Little does he know I don't have anything to come out, but could potentially... I mean, next turn I can Dread Infernal and Mortal Coil this thing. Just to have something on the field. And I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. Big guy comes out as well, which we could potentially drop. Let's see, if I take an additional damage, drops down to 3. Well, no, we can't get it this turn, but we can probably get it next one. So, the other option is Hellfiring and doing this, but... Let's see, if we wipe the board and put a big threat... No, we can't. No, we can't, actually. So, let's see. If it takes 3 damage, it brings it down to 1, right? 4, 5, 6, 7... Yeah, let's do it that way. See how that works. Very risky, but I'm gonna be getting to a point where Hellfires are not gonna be an option, so... Let's do that. So, out comes the Hellfire. Boom! Brings it down to a 1 cost. And we... summon that. And I'm not going to Life Tap anymore because I'm too low in health. Dread Infernal, still an option available. Dealing 1 damage to small creatures. And if it's a 2 coster, I can still Mortal Coil it to get another card and get rid of it. But we now have a big threat on the field that could potentially, you know, give us that edge. So Arcanine Reaper goes for me. Ugh. That's painful. In this situation, ooh, an A-bomb. That's nice. Still hits us anyways, but pretty nice. We have to get rid of the questing adventurer anyway. And the way that we're going to do that is... It's just a Shadow Bolt, yeah. A bit of a waste of damage, but we have to Shadow Bolt. And I don't... No, we do have to put the A-bomb out there. Stop his Arcanine Reaper. It's going to deal 2 damage to us, but it's better than 5. So, yeah. So, A-bomb comes out. We get rid of his questing adventure, because otherwise it's going to get too huge. And we hit him for 8. So, with the Arcanine Reaper, he can take 4 damage to himself, dealing 2 damage extra to me, and if he has any type of charger, like a Korkron Elite, which is very popular with warriors, then I die. So he goes for me. Armor's up. Negate the damage that he's gonna get, so that's nice for him. Yeah, we're too low in health. I don't think we're coming out of this one. The other option is executing my molten giant, but pretty sure he has a charger. Yep. How about I call it? And Korokron Elite comes out. I die, and two losses right away with our warlock. So we are doing horribly, ridiculously horribly. Bad. Oh my god, two losses already to start. We've had runs start like this, and they've turned out pretty well. I think I have a couple of those recorded that you've seen, but Jesus, I'm not feeling very good about this one. And we are already don't have enough gold for our next one, so this is going to be bad. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.